you just get so involved with it, and then you get these idiots down it, so you go, if you're having a bad time, say you're playing it in front of a room full of people, it's only a game. It's not only a game, that's the thing. Say one of my favourite, probably yeah, my favourite football manager career, have to be a career I did with a French amateur team called Saint Noir Saint Gratien. Don't really know what I chose them. I just wanted a challenge really. Obviously I'd done a lot of careers in England. I think when you do a career of football manager, it can get a little bit repetitive maybe if you do it the same country a lot. I wanted something where I'd be getting completely different players in, and I had this idea of maybe revolutionising a French club.
Here's a funny story, actually. Back when I was working in soccer in real life, I'd come home after a day at the office and play FM, and I just spent most of my time just like going over contracts or writing press releases to talk to the media or, you know, other tasks that are associated with working for a football club. Well, this one night, my wife had enough of that, and our scenes kind of went something like this. It was like, "Don't you think you have a problem?" I was like, "Me? What do you mean?" She's, "Well, you know, you come home from a long day at work and now you're playing a game that mimics what you've been doing all day." I see what you mean, but I'm managing Inter, and, you know, these are plays that people have heard of.
Probably the best was taking Plymouth hometown up to Champions League winners and Premiership winners and turning down the Man United job to stay with Plymouth. Hometown hero, that's probably my favourite. I spent a lot of hours on that.
I think games are always stylized playing experiences, and I think you can't play a game effectively if you think you're really living in it.
Taking them through the leagues, and you're getting like an influx of the British invasion, getting all the old English players. In the end, I managed to do this with players such as Lee Bowyer and Nobby Solano. So I went on the website, I used to like going on the websites and finding a lot about the clubs. So I went on the website, checked out Saint Noir, and I saw they had these amazing fans with big flags. And this is obviously, a semi-professional amateur side. And I really liked the idea of their fans getting really behind them and really passionate. So I was like, right, maybe this is the club for me. It was a tiny ground. There's something there, and I was like, looked at their team.
Okay, another point to make is that playing games is real.
Yeah,
you know,
I like this club. I remember Silvio Brillure, the centre forward. Now with Saint Noir, I got them from the French National League, which is the bottom tier, and I went all the way into Ligue 1, and Silvio Brillure stayed with me all through it, and I loved it. He banged in 40 in the first season, slowly got a little bit less, and I think by the end he was playing one game a year, but I just kept him because I was like, he's been there through the whole of it, fans' favourite, and I was never letting him go.
I'm sure there are people who use games as a way of withdrawing from other forms of activity, cultural activity, other forms of communication with family members or friends. But by and large, I think the games are part and parcel of people's everyday lives, part and parcel of their friends, you know, their media consumption, their friendships, their play, whether adults or children.
I think I could be, yeah, because sometimes I'll be like when I was younger and I used to do my paper round, I used to pretend I was the manager answering questions from the press and stuff while I was walking around. And I'd just think about my team not to pass the time and stuff. And I think that's quite an addictive trait.
Well, there are obvious signs of addiction when it comes to playing football manager. I mean, people can suffer from obsessive thoughts, I mean, uncontrolled cravings. I mean, you focus all your energy onto the game and well, these are all classic signs of addiction, and they're also signs which can be applied to football manager.
In the end, I ended up getting Champions League football for this non-league side. Finest hour by far was a 3-1 win at home to AC Milan in the Champions League. And I remember after the game, there's 4,000 fans packed inside the ground, and I asked to expand the stadium, but I couldn't expand the stadium because the local residents vetoed it because they didn't want the ground to be expanded. So I was playing Champions League football regularly with 4,000 fans in this small French village. And I put Saint Gratien, or maybe Saint Noir, don't know what, yeah, it must be Saint Noir. Put it on the map. And one day I think I'd like to maybe go down to Saint Noir. maybe watch a game down there?
I think it's hard to generalise. I think different games have different forms of realism within them. So when people talk about games being more realistic, sometimes they mean the look of the game. So it looks more like more photorealistic. So it looks more like a film. And there are then anxieties that some distinction between that the actual world and the virtual world is being dissolved.
Well, there are many instances of the game crossing over into real life. I mean, the most recent one that I can think of is Everton actually signing a deal with Cygames in order to use their vast database of players in order to scout for future players, future prospects.
I do think FM would help train people to become good managers, but in real life there are so many other things that, you know, come into play, and it's hard really to comprehend. For example, you've just signed a promising striker from Brazil, you know, who's booking his flight, you know, picking him up from the airport, helping him settle in a new city, you know. Where is he living temporarily before, you know, getting a place of his own? Like, how's all his stuff reflective of the budget, you know? But at the end of the day, FM's an amazing game, but it's not real life, you know. You're not dealing with humans.
It's not only a game, that's the thing. People invest so much of your time into this thing that you're investing so much into this game. And like, if people say things like that, it's, I'm putting this much time, I need to just keep playing it, and can I get these results? And you just want to get the results.
I think the lines can be blurred. Like, I think maybe, you know, sometimes you can sort of think, I thought that player played for them, I know that's on my league. So you've obviously got too immersed in the game and you're starting to blur the lines, which I think with some games could become pretty dangerous.
Well, there are some serious instances where the game can lead to these signs of addiction, but in an extreme manner. I mean, one example I can think of is a man who writes on the forums, or they used to, and he bought the game for his son one Christmas. And before he knew it, he'd been involved in quite a serious car accident, and he woke up in hospital a few weeks later with it. Woke up in hospital a few days later with some quite serious injuries, and since then he's just not played the game. Like an alcoholic, he had to just go cold turkey and just cut it completely out of his life.
And I don't know why I keep playing it. I just have to. I just want to keep bettering myself. I just love the game. I just love it. It's just, I suppose it's for us losers that we're not going to be a football manager. We're not going to be a player. So we have to, I don't know, act out our dreams through a 14-inch laptop screen. And now with a 3D pitch, it's getting a bit more disturbing how addictive it's going to become, I suppose, because you actually think, maybe I am Jose Mourinho. And there have been cases I've heard where people have applied for jobs at clubs and sent in their CVs as football manager. I think I'd probably be favourite.
Hello darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone.
Safe. Oh, I've just been offered the Norwich job in all of that.
Really? Well, you were playing the whole time.